Welcome back, everyone. As we have studied that horizontal milling machine, now this one we can convert into a vertical milling machine. How? So therefore here, now I will convert this one to a vertical milling machine. What has to change in this diagram? Only we will change that one only. So this total, this part is there at the bottom side, the which part we have drawn to give a support to the workpiece and for the movement for the workpiece, that will be remains same for the vertical milling machine. Means up to here, this bottom part it is there, it is same in case of the vertical milling machine also. Means here the workpiece can move up and down by the knee, horizontal movement by the saddle, and that it can move perpendicular from the blackboard by the work table. This is same here. So next one, as in case of the vertical milling machine, the axis of the milling cutter through which, about which it is rotating, it is vertical. Here it is horizontal. For vertical milling machine, so this the axis will be a vertical like this here. So like this, this is a vertical axis of the milling cutter through which, about which it is rotating like this here. So next, what has to change? We have to change only top part of this diagram here. So just I will remove this top part in this diagram. Yes, this is a top part I am removing here now. So next, I will take some little bit of that curved shape, this frame here. Then we have to fix a spindle here. So one important part, this is the spindle here. So spindle is graduated like this. Graduated, markings are there here. Markings for what here? Spindle can be swiveled. Swiveled means it can be rotate like this also. Total, this here it is milling, that cutter is there. It can be swivel like this here. It can swivel that like this by rotating some angle. This is the angle graduations are there here. So therefore, here this is the spindle nose, it is called as a spindle nose here, spindle nose. And next one is the, here is the main, that spindle body will starts here, this spindle body. This spindle body can move up and down by one wheel. It is wheel have a handle here. It is a spindle handle. Spindle handle. By rotating this one, this will spindle will move up and down. And this spindle will be, that is rotated. Spindle will be rotated. It will rotate like this here now. It will rotate here now by the motor here. Here is the, that is a motor here. Motor. The electrical connection is given, then once if you on this motor, then the spindle will starts rotating. Spindle can move up and down here by the spindle, that wheel here now. And the here is a one swivel knob is there. This by the swivel knob we can swivel like this also, as I have told here. The next one is for this spindle here, sometimes it is also called as a spindle nose here. Then we are fixing a cutter here, milling cutter here like this. Here the milling, that is a cutter here. This milling cutter will rotate because of this spindle, it is fitted to the spindle here. Only this much has to change in case of the horizontal milling machine. Then now it will become a vertical milling machine because this axis is vertical here now. So therefore, what we can do it here, do here now? So the once we can swivel it spindle, and we can move this spindle up and down by this wheel, and this cutter will rotate and throw this spindle by this motor here now. So this is the diagram how we can change for the vertical milling machine. Only the axis is vertical here in this case. Now we will take another the important that topic here, that are the operations of the milling. So the operations which one we are doing for horizontal milling machines are different, and operations which one we are doing by the vertical milling machines are different here. So now we will study in the next video lecture the operations of the milling that machines. So now I will stop here. I will continue in the next video lectures, operations of milling machines. Thank you.